Hi, I'm Michelle Carlin. I'm out here at the Wesco Center, and I'm with Kenneth, and we're going to talk a little bit about Tai Chi today. He's the instructor here, so I'm going to let him fill us in on that. How are you doing?
Good. I'm doing great. How about you?
I'm doing fantastic.
Good. I'll tell you a little bit about what Tai Chi is. Tai Chi originally started as a martial arts in China, and over the hundreds of years, it's been refined to where it's used primarily for health, to improve your overall general health.
So tell me a little bit about the different postures that you take whenever you're performing Tai Chi.
Well, the postures, they're literally hundreds of different postures. Most are named after animal movements, like the repulsed monkey. As an example, some are named after just exactly what you're doing. The form that we do actually involves some Qigong as well. So it can cover a lot of territory on the forms themselves. And of course, they're just like yoga. They're postures, and then we move and put them together in a flowing manner. And it's actually called moving meditation. The difference between Tai Chi and Kung Fu is that it's basically the same moves, but it's done in slow motion. Tai Chi is primarily a defense. It's not to attack someone, it's to defend yourself against an attacker on it. And it's pretty much that way with all martial arts. You know, they're attack and defend, but this is primarily a defense.
How many people do you have usually that would come to your groups, and when are the groups?
Our classes are on, this is free classes at the Wesco Center here on 57th Avenue in Lillian. We start at 9, and they go from about 9 to 10. And usually I have about 30 in each class. And like I said, I do have night classes too for persons that want special training, you know, like sword forms or other styles. Our style is primarily the Sun style. And it's for arthritis, but we also do Yang style, which is actually the world's most popular form of Tai Chi.
And this young lady joining me now is Catherine. So Miss Catherine, tell me, why did you join the Tai Chi class?
Well, I was told it would help me with my balance. I have bad balance. I was on medication for high blood pressure. I've been doing this just for about 2 months. I'm a baby at it, and I'm no longer on my blood pressure medicine. Yeah, it's a miracle.
That's fantastic.
And my balance is still shaky, but it's better than it was in just 2 months. So I've noticed the difference.
So do you have a particular move that you prefer? He was telling me that they go by different names, a lot of them by, you know, animal names and things like that. Do you have one that you prefer?
No, because I'm new. I follow Ken. In fact, I'm going to be taking his class Monday nights because it'll be more one-on-one. And I come here early before 9 a.m. to get as much one-on-one training as possible. But I don't know the names of the moves yet. I just know to follow him or follow one of the assistant instructors.
So whatever works, huh?
Yes, exactly.
So this is something that you would recommend to family and friends?
Oh, yes. I look forward to it. It's Tuesdays and Thursdays, and I'll be coming on Monday nights as well. And I look forward to it. It's helped my whole demeanor, my attitude toward life. I don't know a lot about the philosophy, but I love it. It's helped me a lot. I can feel it.
Mm-hmm. Palms away, stretch that spine. And release, and just relax. Okay, we're going to just turn our hips down, let the arms dangle. Just turning those hips, making sure everything's working. All right. Let's go down to the waist now. You can bend your knees just a bit. Get the head level and the eyes focus straight ahead, and rotate the hips in a circle. Just like you're doing a hula hoop, but not a hula hoop. Now I got the highest compliment paid to me yet. A yawn. That means you're totally relaxed. That's a good sign. Either that or you didn't get no sleep last night. Let's rotate the opposite direction. This time you get to push out your derriere.
Do have you had any special cases that have came in where people maybe say somebody was having trouble walking because of arthritis or something like that, and they've taken your class and now they can just get up and move around real freely?
Actually, we do. I was just talking earlier about one of my students that came in at age 89 and was having a serious problem with balance and falling and actually busting his head a couple of times. And he's been in my class now for 4 years. He's now 93 years old, and he does quite well, hasn't fallen but once. And that wasn't his fault.
Oh, wow.
Yeah, so it builds the balance, builds the bones, builds the tissue around the bones, so that it gives you better balance and strength. In a bit, I'd like to show you a demonstration of what it actually does do.
Well, I've been taking it now for a couple of years, and I'm not good at it, but I enjoy it, and it keeps me limber, but my knees are bothering me, and I hope to get them in better shape, but that's the reason I'm here.
Okay, so how has it helped you? I mean, I heard that you were having a little bit of a balance problem, and
so
tell me about
that. Some of that, and when I first started, I had broken ligaments in my shoulder, and they're still broken, but I've got to where I can move it, and I couldn't hardly raise it above my shoulders before.
Wow.
But they're in good shape. Still broken ligaments, but the other part of it works.
This is kind of like it's not just a good exercise for everybody, but it's also just like a social gathering, correct?
Right, yeah.
Very cool.
Yeah, we enjoy coming in, talking to each other every morning.
Cool. Well, thank you for joining me, Mr. Curtis. I appreciate it.
You're quite welcome. Thank you.
All right, let's take our right foot and push it forward, heel and toe. Take the toes and pull them back until the calf moves. You can make sure it's tight. Pick up the toe, raise the heel. Remember, you want all your weight on your left hip now. By doing these exercises,
you
influx the lungs and the bloodstream with oxygen. You oxidize the blood, and it gives you more strength, energy, and of course it goes right to the brain. So over a period of time, depending on the individual, the brain does increase in size. And this is not something that I say. This is according to the Harvard School of Medicine.
Whisper in your ear, and you're going to do what I tell you to do, and I will show you the difference.
Well, good luck on that.
Just face the cat. No, I'm not going to hurt you at all. What I want you to do is just stand there comfortably, put your hands down. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to reach over with my hand. Everything we do is gently. We don't jerk you around, and I'm going to just pull you off balance.
Okay.
Now I'm going to whisper something in your ear, and we're going to do the exact same thing.
Okay.
I want you to follow the instruction.
Okay.
Now we're going to do the same thing. Did you see what happened there?
I did.
Did you feel it?
That's very cool.
Yeah, it's what we're doing is completing aura in your body. And I will show you. You'll learn, pressure points and meridians in the body. How to do stuff that really are good parlor tricks, because people are freaked out when you do this.
That was very cool.
But it makes you very solid, very strong.
Mm-hmm.
It's just doing one that simple thing. If they want to know what that is, they'll have to ask Michelle.
That's our secret.
You whisper in your ear. Put your tongue on the roof of your mouth, right behind your teeth. Right behind your teeth. That's what I did when I was holding it there.
The big event we have coming up, it comes up on the last Saturday of April each year. It's called World Tai Chi and Qigong Day. And it started about 2004 in Kansas City with a couple that were really into Tai Chi. And since 2004, it spread to now over 80 different countries and hundreds of different cities. We start that at exactly 10 o'clock a.m. And each time zone will start at exactly 10 o'clock, and it goes all the way around the world in that manner. And it's just to, if you see on the front of my shirt there, it says, you know, one breath, one world. We believe that everybody's basically the same, and Tai Chi sort of brings us all together. But it's basically for health, show other people what we're doing so they can improve their health and live a healthy lifestyle.
Right between your shoulder blades. Now just exhale and relax. Again, up and back. Exhale and relax. One more. Now let's do the same thing. We're going to go forward this time. Inhale up. Push into the front. Exhale and relax. Yes, real easy. Now if it hurts you, don't do it. One more.
Push down. We have a lot of what you call couch potatoes that have not really ever done any exercise. So I start everybody off with just two classes a week, usually about 45 minutes to an hour on it. And we do a warm-up, a meditation, and then we do our practicing our forms. And we usually have a cool-down and a meditation at the end of it. In the beginning, the philosophy, the Chinese philosophy, was that in the beginning there was Wu Qi. Wu Qi is nothingness. It's like in our version is the void. And then there was Tai Chi, which is energy, life, and that's what we are. We are just, you know, bundles of energy.
Know anything that you can tell me, Mr. Jeff, about the Tai Chi. And I see here that you're assistant instructor, so give me some input.
Tai Chi is the one point where you achieve balance. Traditional exercises tears muscle to build up muscle. That's why you go to the gym, no pain, no gain.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Tai Chi does not tear muscles. It exercises muscles at a stately rate. Okay. So the movement that you achieve gives you balance. Now, anybody can go around and say they have balance, but to have balance and grace that prevents you from falling is a big deal. At our age, as seniors, and Ken has taught us Tai Chi for arthritis, and notice the music is going very, very gentle and slow. There's a reason for that. We go gentle and slow. We don't rush, okay?
It's not disco.
No, it's not disco. But what you find is you have gentle movements that come like this. This is called a brush knee. And you have a gentle movement. These are prescribed movements, and they exercise different points in the body. Okay? And Tai Chi is weight shifts. Just watch my legs. And the weight shifts that go back and forth balance you. You strengthen stuff down below, at your hips, in the rear, and in your brain, and you become more confident in just simply walking and standing. The biggest thing about, I think it's sixth, a likely cause of death in seniors is falling. Falling. You hear about it all the time. Tai Chi prevents a lot of that. It helps with your general health because it exercises organs within the body. Muscles in the body with no strain. One of the most common statements he makes is, do this, but if it hurts, stop and back off. Never ever do anything to the hurting point. And you can learn it. We've got guys, I think you talked to Curtis, he's 92. You know, I'm 68. And I can do stuff at 68, balance wise, that the ordinary person doesn't. You look in the obituaries all the time. People a lot younger than me are in the paper. Okay, so it helps. It helps with your breathing. The Harvard School of Medicine says the majority of our ailments are from breathing incorrectly. In Tai Chi, we breathe with our stomach. Infantile breathing. The baby started out right. We learned it wrong after that. Infantile breathing. You get 20% more oxygen in your lungs. Well, there's a whole bunch of things that Tai Chi is good for. It's good for your mental well-being because you feel better. Okay?
Gives you a purpose in life, so to speak.
It's something else to do, of course. Mm-hmm. You know, but I do other things as well. Everybody in this class does. But this is a good thing to do. Yeah, I'll live longer because of it.
And speaking of class, I think I might ought to get out of the way.
Yikes.
Okay, we're going to start with our normal warm-up. Everything is done in slow motion. Remember, concentrate on your abdominal breathing. Okay, we're going to start with gathering some chi. Feet are about shoulder width apart. Toes pointed straight ahead. Tongue to the roof of the mouth. Push the crown up. Soften the knees. We're just going to let that spine straighten up. We're going to gather some chi. So inhale up through the nose. Roll the big ball over your head. Exhale. Slowly down. Storing the energy that we've gathered in the delta yin, which is about 3 equivalents to 1 of the navel. Inhale up. Exhale down. Just relax. Each time you exhale, you want to relax.
This is open to the public, you know. We're going to be at the, you know, the, what's the Wahoo Stadium. And this will be at 10 o'clock. If you want to see what it's all about, come down and join us. It's free. And join the world with a Tai Chi moment there.